Actually, I did not give it back to him, but like I lost it. Starting from this, my ambitious heart started to accelerate the intensity of my sins. And the more I sinned, the desire for more pleasure became far greater than my moral constraints. However, through these repeated experiences, I started to realize that the pleasures I gained from my rebellious behavior against God was temporary and was also leading to my destruction. With a heavy heart, I still continued to go to church, and I felt like my sins were too great for forgiveness. It was hard to make eye contact with other people, as I have a great fear of judgment from others. And I tried to make excuses such as, compared to other people, my sins are not that great, to distract myself. So through the youth group and LIT, I learned a lot about God, and God gave me the opportunity to reject my old self and live a new life with my identity in Jesus. Through the gospel, I was able to find out that everyone is a sinner, and even a hint of evil does not meet God's standards. However, there was a solution to this global problem. Jesus, the only Son of God, had died in order for our relationship with God to be restored. It was not through any of our works, but through grace we are saved. In response to this, I have decided to start to engage in discussion groups and ask questions for support interpreting the words from the Bible. The Bible verse that really encouraged me was Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 to 9, which states, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast." So something difficult I was experiencing being a Christian was just forgetting or just getting distracted by the business of my life. And something that was great that happened was that I no longer feared the judgment from God and others. And so last week, I got baptized so I can start to share my hope with other people about God. And for the people who do not trust in Jesus, I would give an encouragement to them that death has already been defeated through the resurrection of Jesus, and through repentance, all of our sins can be forgiven.